Welcome back to PJ Chain Design. Today, I'm going to answer a question from Ren Greenspan, if I pronounce correct your name. It's interesting to looking at this construction for this six-prong setting. So what we're going to do today is kind of discuss two ways to make this type of a setting. Are you ready? Let's get started. So I'm going to walk through my thinking process on this one with you. When we get this six prong here, one thing we can thinking about is to making each of the U shape, and then we polar array, and then so that we'll call it done. The other way that we're thinking about is we have a whole block, and we kind of create certain of a cutting tool and to cut out the shape like this. So I'm gonna show you both way and see whichever way that you will like it. First of all, we bring in the stone, and if you wanted to know how to make the stone, you can look at this video right here. I show you step by step making the stone with all the cuts there. So if you're interested, check out this video. Once you have the stone, I bring the stone in, whatever the size that you want it to be. Mine happen to be roughly about 8 millimeters, something, a big diamond there. And then I'm going to making the surface that go around it. So I'm going to use this command. And then we are going to set it up to the zero. Depends on how high you want it. I usually will like to have my prong longer than the table. So that way I will have the prong, enough prong to bend over. So I want to have something like this. And if this is like too tall to you, not like a picture there, maybe the girdle is way too high, we may want to scale 1D down and still moving up a little bit. Okay, so that will be the position that we have. Thinking about you're going to offset inside or outside, you want to make sure your prong is not cutting more than 20% of the prong thickness by the stone. So that's what we wanted to look into it. All right, so now we got that. The second things we wanted to do is we need to make sure that it's evenly spread it out for the six prong. So let's do the command. Going to be divide, and we're gonna divide this outer edge for about six of them. So we want to make sure the segment is six, and then we click OK, then we get those dot there. Once we get those dot, if you take a picture, if you take a detailed look on this, those dot is represent the location on the top six prong, and they are coming down to the bottom, and the bottom is halfway of the six prong. So what we wanted to do is we're gonna pick up those top 6 points, Control C and Control V, make a duplication and scale them down like that small. Also notice they are now completely aligned with the bigger circumference point there. So what we wanted to do is rotate it about 30 degrees. So that will be right in the middle. I also wanted to move those down roughly somewhere like this. Okay, so now let me hide the stone. And let's just take a look on this. And I'm gonna hide this one as well. As you can see, we have those dots from outside, those dots from inside. And we need to draw a line that is definitely past those points, right? So let's go ahead to use the curve tool. You got two curve tools right here, control point curve and interpolate point. At this scenario, we want to make sure we use an interpolate point, and so that will go through the point exactly. Okay, now let's take a look on the perspective. Now, if I turn on my surface, I could use that to pull back to the surface, but then when I need to have a thickness, that won't be accurate enough. So what I do to make it super accurate, I'm going to select this one and project to the C plane, and I want to delete the input. So now they are completely flat to the bottom. So next things I wanted to do is I want to extend this curve. So let's go into the extend the curve, by line, and I'm just needed to go straight because I just needed to be over the edge there. And then so we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. We wanna extend it, this one, and turn on the smart track so we'll make sure that they come up the same height. Now we have this, let's go ahead to rebuild it so it will be more even. Let's go ahead to try to use 7 point, look nice, let's click OK. So we are going to make a copy of this to other layer, and then we might need to use them later on, so let's just go ahead and hide that layer. So one thing I would like to do is I would like to offset this one. So first things is offset your curve. I'm going to make my prong is about 1 millimeter, so offset on both sides. And for 0.5 millimeter each, so this is the new curve that I get. I always like to rebuild the curve and make sure they are nice and smooth. All right, so now we have this, we can pick up those two and use those two curves to trim the surface over there. So now you can see we will have this surface over there. Let's turn on the stone and see how that fit in there. Okay, so if that look all right to you, let's make it into the solid by offset the surface, and we want them to come in outside, and then we want to make sure it is solid, right? So make sure that's not cutting too much of a stone, and then roughly about 20%. Okay, so double check if they look all right, then we can have that using the polar array, and we want to create 6 of them for 360 degree, and we can get something like this. If you like this one, that would be great. We'll just use this one, but I kind of noticed the top, it fit it perfectly because the curvature right here, you can see you have this overlapping there, right? So they may not be super good. This little things over here is not a problem. We can just make a cutter to cut it out later on in the middle. That will not be the issue. However, that kind of overlapping there is not what exactly I'm looking for. We can also take a look on the render view, right? So the render view, it actually look fine. And if your jeweler kind of polish off that, that might be okay. But I just don't like that a little bit overlapping over there. So I'm going to change another way to do it. The second way we are going to do is first I need to offset that piece coming in for 0.5 millimeter. After that, I'm going to rebuild this guy to make it nice and rounded, and then I'm going to extend it, the curve by line, make this one just a little bit longer, and we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. Make sure your smart track is on, and then you want to snap in here so that will be the same height, and we want to close with the line. Let's go ahead to join all of them. So now this will be our cutter. Before we making the cutter, we want to offset this surface. Let's go ahead to offset outside and solid equal yes for 1 millimeter. And we are going to come in here, extrude the planar curve straight. So let's get something like this. All right, let's do a sample test. We are going to pick up the extrusion, and we are going to do polar array, 6 of them. Center is 0, type is 6 of them, and see if that is the shape that we want. So let's do the bowling and pick up this outer shape and also outer cutter. So then you will have this cut it really nicely. Looking at this surface right here, if this surface is not what you want, you might need to alter the color a little bit. So let's go ahead to pick up the color and just tilt it a little bit and see if that come out better. And we can again polar array, center is 0, number for 360 for 6 of them, and that's what we get. Let's do bowling difference one more time, and let's see if it is better. Alright, so you kind of see the angle right there, see if that is the curve you want. You have a little bit extra there, we can just go ahead and delete those little pieces there. Okay, so once you get that, we also need to cut the balloon design open there. So let's go ahead to duplicate the edges, and it's happened to be the seam that we are picking up. And then so we're gonna make a color follow this, but we don't want to cut it all the way to the top. It's somehow cut it somewhere in the middle of it, or just a little bit above the middle. So let's go ahead to split with the point on this one somewhere about right here, and let's delete this one. Okay, so now we have this curve, I wanted to pipe it over there, but if we pipe it, just stop it right here, you're going to see something like a rounded finish there. If that's what you want, that's fine. If not, let's go ahead to use extended curve by line, and we want to pick up this curve and want to go all the way up, so it's continue over like that long. Next step, we can use the piping tool. We're gonna pipe it something pretty big over here, and then we're gonna have something really small over here, and let's hit enter and see what we come up with. Now we have that one, let's do a test cut. Maybe I make the line way too long, but bowling difference this one out of this one, and yes, I kind of cut it way too high. Maybe I need to go back to make it shorter, but I'm just gonna, for this demonstration, I'm going to using that one. So again, we want a polar array, six of them, 360 degree. So all we need to do is bowling difference, and you can take a look on the render view right now. As I say earlier, I may cut it like too tall, may not want to cut it that long. And this is for the printing file, that's why I make the top is like square and things like that. You need to leave enough room for your jeweler to set the stone for you. I hope you enjoy the video, and I hope Rainbow answered your question. Thank you everybody for watching. Check out my course on my website for the stone setting if you are interested more in the stone setting. See you next time.